Cubital tunnel syndrome is a pinching or irritation of the nerve that occurs on the inside of the elbow. It's also called the funny bone nerve. So patients will tell us usually that they feel numbness or tingling in their small finger and their ring finger, and sometimes some pain on the inside of the elbow. And that can occur with patients spending a lot of time with their elbow in a bent position. Most patients will tell us that they feel like their hand falls asleep at nighttime when their elbow is bent or when they're driving a car. And occasionally they say that their hand or their grip strength feels rather weak.
There are several non-operative options for those with cubital tunnel. The first is activity modification, meaning not putting your elbow in that bent position as that's causing compression of the nerve. Second is to wear braces. These braces generally will either keep your elbow completely stretched out or in an extended position, or they'll stop you from going into full flexion, meaning not letting you bend your elbow all the way up.
Sometimes the compression, the pinching of the nerve at the elbow gets quite severe, and when the hand starts to get weak, we usually recommend surgery to prevent permanent weakness of the hand. Surgery for cubital tunnel syndrome is done as an outpatient, so patients do go home that same day. And it can be done under local anesthetic, so just numbing medicine, and the patient is wide awake, or it can be done with sedation, so the patient is sleepy. It involves an incision on the inside of the elbow, and the surgeon will release the tight band of tissue that's lying over the nerve.
Once the nerve has been released, intraoperatively, the surgeon will test the nerve to see if it's stable. If the nerve isn't stable, they'll do something called an anterior transposition. And that just means we take the nerve from the back of the elbow and we put it in the front of the elbow.
After the surgery, patients should expect a little discomfort around the incision, for which they can take over-the-counter medications. For patients who do light office work for their jobs, they can go back to work almost immediately, a couple of days after surgery. But for patients who do heavy physical activity for their jobs, we usually tell them it can take up to 6 weeks to return to work.
Expected outcomes is largely based on their symptoms before surgery. So patients with more mild symptoms should expect full function, while patients who have more severe cubital tunnel may have some residual deficits.
If a patient was experiencing a lot of weakness before the surgery, in order for them to regain their full function and maximize their recovery, we usually have them work with a hand therapist so they can get their strength back.
After a cubital tunnel release, patients would typically be seen 1 to 2 visits for maybe up to a month would be the typical course of care. Milestones for a patient would include regaining their motion of their upper extremity, being compliant with modifications of activities, including not resting on their elbows or keeping it in a bent position for a prolonged period of time. Some positive outcomes are that they are able to return to the activities, including returning to sport, as well as being able to sleep throughout the night without being woken up by their symptoms.